Hello and welcome to this Lumineth Realm-lords painting video. In this video, we're going to be showing how to paint the armour, the robes and the plumes of the great nation of Syar. Now, I'm going to be using a Venari Oral and Warden as our example. However, the colour scheme can transfer easily onto any of the models in your collection. Now, the first thing we'll need to do is undercoat the model. And as you can see here, we've used Wraithbane, which is perfect for the colours we're going to be applying. Now, I'm going to start first by picking all the metallic trim and also the scale mail out of the model by using Iron Hand Steel. So I'm going to grab a small layer brush for this because I can get a nice point to it. Because obviously those little bits of trim are quite small. So once I've had a little bit of water, I've got a nice point to my brush, and then ready to start picking them out. If I just pull the model up, you can see here you've got lots of little trim around there and you've got the scale mail here. So just take your time. If you do make any mistakes and get on the actual armour panels, just tidy back up with some Wraithbane. There we are with the armour trim and the scale mail now done. We're going to move on to our next step, which is to apply Skeleton Horde Thin Downward Contrast Medium. And once that's dry, we're then going to highlight the trim of the armour using a little bit of Stormhost Silver. But first of all, let's start with our Skeleton Horde and Contrast Medium mix. I'm going to get two dollops, or so it's going to be two parts of Contrast Medium to one part of Skeleton Horde. It's going to mix that together like so. I'm using a medium shade brush here because it's quite large, because we're covering over the whole of the model. So what I'm going to be doing is just painting that all over. I'm including the plume in this as well. That's going to get set up later on when we do the plume. Like you see, I'm coating all over the armour. Now with the metallics, it's actually going to tone it down a bit and give it more of a brass kind of feel to it. So just apply it all over, try not to let it pool too much, and just leave it to dry for around about 30 minutes. There we are with that contrast medium mix now dry. We're going to start highlighting with Stormhost Silver. So I'm just going to start rubbing that on the edges of the trim like so. And then when we get to the scale mail, I'm actually just going to layer over. I'm still showing some of that Skeleton Horde in the recesses. There we are, the armour trim now done. We're going to move on to our next area, which is the robes. Now for this, we're going to start with Baratnar Burgundy as a base coat. We're then going to shade all over using Norn Oil. After that, we're going to layer over, mainly on the robes where the creases are, using Screamer Pink, and then finish off with a fine highlight of Pink Horror. But first of all, let's start that base coat. So I'm just going to get a couple of dollops of Baratnar Burgundy onto my palette. A little touch of water, so it's not too thick. And we're ready to start base coating it. So we've got a few areas to pick. You've got the robes themselves and the inner bit, and also a little sigil there as well. If you can, just avoid that little trim, and if you do make any mistakes, just tidy back up with a little bit of Wraithbane. There we are with the Baratnar Burgundy now base coated. What we're going to do is apply Norn Oil all over. And once it's dry, just some of those raised areas of the robes, just tidy back up with a little bit of Baratnar Burgundy, just for a little bit more transition. There we are, with the shade now dry and any tidying up done, we're going to start highlighting with Screamer Pink. So what I'm going to do is look for folds on the cloth like so, and then start picking out those raised areas. Now this is for the robes here, however when you get the skirt in the middle, I'm actually going to layer that fully until obviously you leave some of the Baratnar Burgundy and Norn Oil just shown in those recesses. So from just one colour you'll get two different effects. There we are with the Screamer Pink now applied. We're going to move on to a final highlight using Pink Horror. So in the centre area where the skirt is, we're just going to highlight those folds of the cloth like so, just down the middle. Then you've just got the little bits here. We're just going to do a little one here and there, just where the light will catch, so not too much at all. And as you can see here, it's starting to give two different effects just by using the same colours, just by layering one and highlighting it, and then just edge highlighting, and then doing a second highlight on the actual main skirt. There we are with the robes now done. We're going to move on to the plume. Now for this, we're going to start off by using White Scars of Dry Brush. Now obviously we've already done Skeleton Horde, so that's already dry and ready. So this will give it some nice definition. After that, we'll use some Volupus Pink, just around the top parts of the actual plume, then finish off by using Baratnar Burgundy, just on the tips to darken it down. But first of all, let's start with White Scars. So I'm using a small dry brush for this. I'm just going to get some on my brush, and then I'm going to start wiping it off like so. Now the key thing here is to wipe off as much as you possibly can, just leaving trace elements on those bristles. Sometimes I do circular motions and crisscross, and that helps remove a lot of the pigment from within side of the brush. So once I'm happy with that, I'm then going to start dry brushing that across the plume. So all I'm going to do is go sideways like this, because obviously all the details will be picked out better that way. Just keep doing that, building up. And obviously move around with the contours of the actual plume, because you want to get it on those raised parts, not in the recesses. There we are with the dry brush done. We're now going to use Volupus Pink on the tips of the plumes, or around the top of the plumes. Now I probably won't go no further than these little silver beads, so just keep it around about the top third, like so. There we are with the Volupus Pink now dry. We're going to finish off by using Baratnar Burgundy just on the tips of the plume like so. This is going to give it some nice contrast and make it look a little bit darker as it gets further out. There we are with that plume now done. The armour, robes and plumes of the great nation of Syar is completed. Now remember, when you paint these models, you can easily transfer this colour scheme to any of your Lumineth warriors. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Hope you enjoy painting your own great nation of Syar, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.